I'm Ron Berger, and it has been my deep privilege to be a part of the EL crew since the founding of this organization and this network. One of the things that makes me most proud to be part of EL crew is that we bring a different vision of how to motivate students to care. We believe that every student wants to contribute things of value to the world. We believe that every student wants to contribute things of which they are personally proud, to be able to say, I'm proud of having done that. Beautiful work, acts of courage, compassion, and consequence. There is no school in America that takes that vision more seriously than Harborside Academy in Kenosha, Wisconsin. Harborside is a school that truly, to use an EL phrase, puts service at the heart of learning. It all begins with the extraordinary heart of founding principal Bill Hathcock. And the amazing leadership team and faculty of Harborside, many of whom are here today and deserve our incredible appreciation for their work. But it is manifest in the words you'll hear from these students this morning. It is my incredible honor to introduce to you five Harborside students to inspire us. The first is Ethan, a ninth grader, whom you might recognize from the banner just outside this hallway. He points out that he was younger then. He really looks much more grown up now. And four Harborside graduates, all of whom are highly successful college students right now. Katie, Kahari, Nicole, and Jocelyn. And for all of you school leaders out there who are always recruiting, I just want to let you know that three of these four are considering education as a career right now. And so, as the 2016 student keynote speakers for EL Education, join me in welcoming Harborside Academy's students.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. My name is Ethan Myers, and last year, I had a decision to make. This decision will not only change the next 4 years of my life, but beyond. I had to choose between going to a traditional high school or a choice school, Harborside Academy. And although both would prepare me academically for college, I was looking for something different, and I wasn't sure what that was until I stumbled across this message.
Hi, my name is Emily Swanson, and I'm a senior at Harborside Academy. With so many choices for high school, you want to make sure the school you choose is a good fit for you. Harborside Academy is a KUSD charter high school and offers college preparatory curriculum. Harborside Academy is an expeditionary learning school. Students do more than listen to lectures and answer questions out of a textbook. They are researchers, they are investigators, they are explorers. Students work independently and in groups to find answers. They're active participants in learning expeditions. Our curriculum focuses on a college preparatory program of study and is demanding. Our curriculum is integrated among core subject areas, English, science, history, and whenever possible, math and electives. There's a strong emphasis on group work and project-based learning. In addition to our integrated curriculum, there's an outward bound component to our school. Students participate in field work, overnight camping trips, trust and leadership building activities. Harborside has a strong emphasis on character. We have very traditional views about the ways individuals behave, treat, and interact with each other. A prerequisite for a student to earn credit in any class is that they have a passing character grade. Harborside is a close-knit community. Every student is part of a crew. Students and staff build strong relationships that are based on respect and mutual trust. Service learning is another core principle at Harborside Academy. Students participate in service learning through outreach projects, crew-sponsored initiatives, and individual volunteering. Where will you go to high school? In KUSD, the choice is yours. I chose Harborside because I didn't want to just sit in a classroom and read out of a textbook. I wanted to like and be passionate about what I was learning. Harborside gave me in-class learning with out-of-class discovery. My school also focuses on me as a person, not just a student or a number. I encourage you to think about what you want to accomplish in the next 4 years. Harborside will not only help you discover your potential, but develop the confidence to show it. You have more in you than you know.
The unique approach to teaching academics interested me, but what really drew me in was the extra emphasis on character building and community service. This was that special something I was looking for, and the choice seemed clear to me. Harborside Academy was where I would fit in and where I would belong.
Hello everyone, my name is Katie Carlson and I'm a Harborside graduate. At Harborside, we live the motto,
leave a place better than you find it.
That truly prepares us for life. We were individuals who learned that leaving a place better than you find it doesn't just mean picking up after yourself wherever you may go. It's looking at the world around us and finding ways in which we can change the world.
Mottos like,
no one eats alone at Harborside,
go far beyond the table of the cafeteria. It's about noticing those around you that are in need. These mottos speak of the heart of Harborside's purpose. Hello, everyone. My name is Jocelyn Aguirre, and as a current undergraduate at the University of Wisconsin-Parkside, I know that I am on the same playing field as my classmates. However, what sets me apart from my peers are the skills that I learned through service learning that were so powerful in our expeditions.
Thank you, Jocelyn. My name is Nicole Hyatt. Service learning is the heart and soul of Harborside. Don't get us wrong, though. Academics is the anchor, but service learning is the heart of our curriculum.
That's true, Nicole. My name is Kahari Bell, and I know what you are thinking. Sounds too good to be true, right? The pressures and fears that high-stakes testing creates, that if schools break away from academics to focus on service learning, performance will decline. Don't dismiss service for the sake of losing academic rigor. They need to coexist. Don't sacrifice what gives purpose to what you teach us and what we want to learn. We are going to show you how at Harborside, both academics and service coexist to create results all schools should strive for. Because students can get smart to do good. Ethan, can you take us back to sophomore year?
Sure, Kahari. During sophomore year, I will experience an expedition that focuses on world conflict. It comes alive through its central lens, the eyes of U.S. veterans. The curriculum is driven by historical perspectives on war through interviews of veterans and others who have experienced the effects of war firsthand. Let's listen to Susan Nelson, for example, the mother of a U.S. Marine who sadly did not make it home from his second deployment.
It is true that Kristen had Marines come to her door. She was actually expecting a friend to come over. They were going to go out to the Y and do their workout. But then when she saw the Marines, her first reaction was, wow, our anniversary is in one week, our 1 year anniversary, and they're here to bring me flowers. And she was so thrilled that he would go out of his way to do that for her. And a separate group of five Marines came to our door at the same time. When I went to the door and opened that front door, I knew they weren't there to deliver flowers to me. I had, again, it was a second deployment, and even though it was safe, war is never safe. And so I opened the door and I saw them, and my first reaction was I slammed the door and just walked away. I ran away. And I did that about four times. I'd go to the door, I looked at all the guys on the front porch, slam the door, and run away. Finally, the last time I did that, I opened the door and I just said, can you guys wait here a minute? I finally could say something. And I ran down the basement and I screamed for my husband to come. And he actually thought I was screaming because I saw a bug or something, so he comes running thinking he's going to rescue me from this insect, you know, or this bug. And I just dragged him to the front door. I couldn't even say why he was up there. And I had him open the door, and that's... So after that, after those few minutes, maybe the guys were there, the Marines were there, maybe a half hour, maybe 45 minutes, I said, we need to get over to Kristen. Because I knew here was this gal who had just turned 20 years old, and had just gotten this horrible news. And so we went over there. Kristen's response, she could not talk. She did not say one word that entire night and just stared straight ahead. And I just sat with my arm around her.
It's through interviews like this that I will learn far more about the impact of conflict than any textbook could ever teach me.
Listening to the many stories our veterans shared with us, we realized that the stories of their youth were not much different from our own. Some grew up in poor neighborhoods and had to help raise their brothers and sisters, much like many of us have had to do. Some had to get jobs early in their life just to help their parents pay the bills and be financially sustainable. Whatever the connection was, we became passionate about telling the story of our veterans to show our appreciation for their sacrifices. Because, in a way, part of their story was also part of our story, too.
A sad reality that struck us was that the veterans we had worked closely with in the past are no longer able to work with us because we began seeing their funeral announcements in the paper. After one funeral, the daughter of that vet came to us and thanked us for creating the documentary of her father because they played our work during his service to share his story with all those who came to pay their respects. At that moment, we knew that the frustrations and the struggles we faced to produce the vision we wanted was worth it because of the impact our work had on the community.
Through the knowledge we gained from our academic courses, we started a 5K honor run to raise our awareness for the veterans and the multiple issues that they faced. This run helped us to raise funds to honor our veterans. For example, we connected with our city and a local artist to help put up a statue across the street from our school. And soon, we will send our veterans to Washington, D.C. on an honor flight.
At the end of the expedition, we hold our culminating event dinner, where local veterans become our guests of honor. There, we cook and serve a pasta dinner before they're escorted to a ceremony where we present our documentaries and they receive a Medal of Character as the highest honor that we can give to them. Then we sing, play music, or read poetry that was written for them.
The culminating event was a time for me to share my passions and appreciation with our veterans. Through my music, I share my interpretation of their struggles. And if you listen, the music tells a story. I wrote Footsteps with the image in my mind of a veteran returning home from war and having to take those first steps again as they adapt back to life at home.
At our ceremony, we even like to surprise our guests, just like we want to do right now. In the spirit of Harborside, we are going to take this opportunity today to honor the veterans in the audience. We ask that if you are currently serving, have served, or lost someone in your family from serving, please stand so that we may recognize your sacrifice by presenting to you our Medal of Character while Katie performs for you her original piece titled Footsteps.
Thank you.
Thank you for your sacrifice.
When I saw that Harborside emphasized service learning like this, this was that special something I was looking for. This exact reason is why I chose Harborside and look forward to the education I will gain. It makes me excited to wonder, what is still to come?
Ethan, did you know that childhood obesity rates have more than doubled in children and quadrupled in adolescents in the past 30 years? The percentage of children aged 6 to 11 increased by 11% from 1980 to 2012. The percentage of adolescents aged 12 to 19 increased by 16% over the same period of time. The Food for All expedition grew from the roots of poverty and unhealthy eating in our community.
We looked at elementary students in Kenosha Unified receiving free and reduced lunch and identified the students receiving those services, targeting those higher than 90%. Students and their families rely and depend on school lunches as a source of nutrition and as a daily meal. However, healthier foods like fruits and vegetables tend to be absent from these meals.
We saw an opportunity to make an impact on our community and became advocates for healthier eating. The community heard our voice, and the local business donated 5 acres of land for Harborside to start a garden. Our dream of creating a community based on healthier eating was becoming a reality. But we had one problem. Okay, kind of a huge problem. Money. We didn't have any. We finally had land to start a garden, bodies to work it, but nothing to fund it.
Mark my words, when kids are passionate about a service in their community, they will overcome obstacles. We look to grant writing as a source for money. If you want a real audience for student writing, have them complete grant applications for issues they are passionate about.
Through a successful grant application, we were able to build garden beds for our school and connect with 2 other elementary schools to build garden beds at their school as well. We created lessons to help educate their students about how to care for their gardens, as well as maintain healthy eating habits. But we knew that 2 schools just was not enough, and we needed to do more. We worked with a local college to write a second grant to expand our efforts to 19 more elementary schools. That means that 21 out of 24 elementary schools in our district now had access to fresh foods that they could grow and pick themselves.
Because of these efforts, we were able to join the local outdoor farmers market, where students would sell our produce and educate the shoppers that would come through. By providing fresh foods and by advocating for those who couldn't afford them, we were able to get the market to accept SNAP, WIC, and farmers' checks as means of payment.
The education we gained by studying environmental sustainability and environmental law issues has made it possible for my fellow graduates to continue establishing community and college gardens that extend to a national level, all the way to the East Coast. Slowly, through our school garden, we are creating a community that is focused on healthy eating.
We are living the Harborside motto, leave a place better than you find it.
When I walk the halls of Harborside, it feels different. It feels like what I do and learn matter. Last year's graduates accepted over $1.6 million worth of scholarships, probably because we are recognized not only for our academic success, but for the skills we learn through service learning. I'm excited for my senior year.
In the Seniors to Seniors Expedition, we learn about the aging process, memory, loss of memory, and dementia, with a specific focus on Alzheimer's. Too often, our society tosses aside people that we feel can't offer anything to us, the elderly. People who suffer from Alzheimer's are often discarded. So as senior students, we seek senior citizens and caregivers to find answers to fundamental questions like, what makes up one's humanity? Is age truly just a number?
Should we ever compromise the health of our brain? Why should we worry about others' aging and dementia problems?
If a person has no memories, are they still that same person? Are they still even a person?
In the beginning of our expedition, we played memory games and participated in a virtual dementia tour where we could feel, see, and hear what a day in a life is like for a person living with a disease. In school, we learned about how the brain works, other forms of dementia, physics of movement, technology of brain scans, statistics of Alzheimer's, and examined the current causes and treatment options for those living with the disease.
Every year, students in the senior class are also matched with a senior living with memory loss. We are trained on how to work with our partner, and once trained, we schedule visits and plan activities to do with them. But it is during these visits that we come to realize how this population is neglected. Many do not receive the respect, time, or attention that they need and deserve. We come to understand that our seniors, even though their memory is forever changed, have their heart, their feelings, and humanity still intact.
Our entire senior class serves as volunteers at the annual Walk to End Alzheimer's in September. It is there where we first come face to face with Alzheimer's. We see that the disease impacts more than just the sole individual. Family members, caregivers, community members, teachers, and even high school students. Alzheimer's has a ripple effect on all those who care for the individual suffering from the disease.
For the culminating event, students, senior partners, and all affected by the disease are invited together for an evening social. We compose a creative writing piece that is inspired by our senior partner and our experience with them. We also create an art piece that is inspired by our senior partner's life experiences. This art piece is then presented to our senior partner or their family as a final parting gift. This service learning component enables us to understand the value of humanity, regardless of age, communication ability, or memory. We learn that we all matter at every stage of our existence.
Before we graduate, we do one final service piece through our senior project. Every student plans, fundraises, and implements their own service project that can affect the community, nation, or sometimes even the world. This final step becomes our opportunity to bring service to a topic that we are passionate about. And even though I still have 3 years before my senior project, I've already started to think about how I can impact my community.
For my senior project, I joined a group traveling to Ometepe, Nicaragua. Unfortunately, a majority of the people of Ometepe do not have access to clean, drinkable water. So our mission was to build storing tanks that would provide people access to clean water. We took part in cutting and bending rods that formed the shape of the tank and even made our own cement for the base. But when not working on the tanks, we spent time with the children, like playing baseball in the streets. The community would come out and watch us play, and in those moments, we all felt like part of just one community. While there, I also asked a question. What can people back in the States do to help in situations such as Nicaragua? One local doctor told me, with tears in her eyes, to give their time. You see, because people can donate clothes and shoes and other items, and of course the people are always grateful. But what they need the most is for your time and effort to go to the problem and find solutions. I am living the Harborside motto, leave a place better than you find it.
While Kahari and I were student ambassadors, I met Melissa, who worked for a school in Africa. The school wanted to implement EL, but EL wasn't quite ready to send trainers overseas yet. To my surprise, though, Melissa asked me to accompany her in her next trip to Ramagana, Rwanda. So after a couple months of fundraising, I was able to go with her to Ramagana Lutheran School. The first day, I had an in-service with the teachers, where I told them what I've taken away from Harborside. I showed them the projects I've made, and I read them my personal memoir that showed how Harborside has truly changed my life. While I was there, I also taught English lessons to the students to help them prepare for their national exam. I also led them in crew building activities, such as the famous human knot, of course. After this experience, it made me want to teach abroad after I graduate from college. I am living the Harborside motto, leave a place better than you find it.
For my senior project, I created a documentary that addressed the nation's racial tensions that at that time had only just begun to garner national attention. I wanted to open a dialogue in the community about the relevance of race in our city. So I wrote a proposal to the Community Public Access Channel for production, and my concept was approved. For 2 weeks, I pushed around a studio camera on a tripod to all my classes. Four of my classmates shared their experiences with racial stereotypes. Two senior crews engaged in class discussions about about racial issues in our city. The support of my community and classmates encouraged me as I addressed such a difficult topic. As I wanted to draw awareness to racial issues in our city, I learned more about myself and my own racial identity. Today, I'm an active participant in talks of racial reconciliation on my college campus. I am living the Harborside motto, leave a place better than you find it.
An EL education core practice states, service learning is an integral part of academic work. It teaches us, your students, and all EL students that the skills they are learning can be put to use to make a better community. We have made a difference in our community because our teachers are dedicated to making service learning the heart of our education.
We are unique individuals. Individuals from an urban setting with diverse backgrounds. It doesn't matter if you're white, black, rich, poor, struggle academically, or at the top of our class. Because no one knows and no one even cares. Because when we walk through the doors of Harborside, we are brought together to not only care about each other, but our community.
We would like to leave you today the same way that we leave Harborside, with a This I Believe statement. The This I Believe statement is part of our senior passage and our time to reflect on education and share with our teachers, friends, and family on what we truly believe in. Here is Madeline Nussain's This I Believe.
I believe in the value of a good education, but even more so, I believe in the value of an EL education, and getting lost in the woods with 20 of my classmates and my principal, and wading through a river in middle of nowhere, Illinois, and cheering on my classmates at the annual flag football game, and having a family at school. The first, and probably most important part of an EL education is, of course, the education. The going to the park to take water samples, and chatting with veterans to better understand the wars that our country has been a part of. That textbooks are an enhancement to the curriculum, not the main staple. Textbooks do not equal maize. The second factor is the closeness. We are all a family. It sounds corny, but the truth is that despite any kind of high school drama we've had, Harborside kids always have each other's backs. After all, crowding together on buses after 3 days without a shower, you can't help but be family. Third, our teachers. If our classmates are like our siblings, then our teachers are like our parents. I'm looking at you, Mama Boning and Mama Casper. From singing along to Disney songs to giving me some very profound advice, my teachers have always been the absolute best, both inside and out of the classroom. In my 13 years of schooling, I have never had teachers that are as dedicated, talented, and invested as those that I have had at Harborside. Every day, they inspire me to color outside the lines and be the very best that I can be. And the fourth thing that sets the EL experience apart, the connection to nature. It's not always obvious, but it's always there. Our expeditions all relate to the world around us, not only socially, but also environmentally. We learned how to purify water, grow our own food, and the best ways to produce sustainable energy. Not only do we learn about the environment, but we also experience it. From camping as a class every fall to hiking intensives and geocaching at Character Quest, expeditionary learning and Outward Bound never fail to remind us of the beauty of the planet that we are lucky enough to live on. I believe that I am a better person for having an education as amazing and unique as I have had. When I talk to my friends at other larger schools, they say that they can't wait to graduate. I, on the other hand, am finding myself dreading the final goodbye at the end of this year. And it's all thanks to my EL education, which has made me into the person that I am today.
Thank you for listening. Why we, the students, teachers, administrators of Harborside, believe service is the heart of education.
Hi, everyone. I just want to take this opportunity on behalf of myself and the lovely people I got to spend this incredible journey with. We would like to recognize Melissa Jakubowski, Trent Barnhart, and Bill Haithcock, our principal, vice principal, and someone who is totally key in making all of this come together perfectly. So we'd like to welcome them up here so we can hug them and everything. And
come on
up. Please come on up. And we couldn't have done it without their support. So thank you.
Come on.
Can I borrow a mic? Stay. Everybody stay. Thank you for letting us recover from our tears before any of us had to speak. I suspect I speak for everyone here when I say these three thank yous. Thank you for standing. I thought I'd recovered. Thank you for standing for everything we believe in. Thank you for leaving us better than you found us. And thank you for giving us a memory to hold on to when the work is hard, to remember why we do it and why it matters. I suspect jobs will not be hard to find. I know that I invite you to use me as a reference if it can ever be helpful. And you and Harborside community should be very proud, and we should collectively wish all of you very safe travels, happy rest of year, and let's go forth and celebrate what we do and why we do it, motivated by these fine students. Thank you.